hi and welcome back to this, because now the celestial ball has come out. And I see one of these dresses I have not... Wow, it's floral. I want the floral one. I've already decided that. Oh, never mind. Hogwarts celestial ball is here. Who will you choose to go with? I mean, I can't even say words anymore. This is so awesome. I mean, I'm almost slightly disappointed the chapter didn't come out, but celestial ball, oh my god. I just can't wait for this. I cannot. Never mind, I'm not reading this. I cannot say words. Come on. I'm going. Oh man, I can't wait for this. Oh boy. I didn't expect it to come today at all. Oh, loading, please don't make me wait. Not today. Oh, not today. Okay, the loading. Okay. What? Oh, is it always been this bright in the Great Hall? No. Ismaelda, no one can force me to have fun. True. Okay, this is going a little wonky today. Is that supposed to be Ben? Yeah. Mysterious gatherings make me anxious. Ben, relax. I heard Dumbledore is announcing a special event. I'm in. I feel like I'm forgetting something. What am I forgetting? Oh, I got it. But it can wait. I suppose you're wondering why I've called you all here. Yeah. It is not to remind you to pick up after your pets in the castle. Okay, I suppose that's... Never mind. Though the behavior is strongly encouraged. Yeah, okay, yeah. We get a point. I don't have a pet. I mean, in real life, so I don't exactly... Was that directed at me? My toad isn't housebroken. I'm sorry, I don't know what housebroken means, but the sentence still sounds funny. I'm stupid. It is with great pleasure that I announce to you that Hogwarts Celestial Ball is fast approaching. It is a festive event for your year held in the Great Hall. Where exactly am I sitting? Maja, shut the door. Every time is the same story. There will be music, decorations, refreshments and dancing. I suck at all of those. Hey, Charlie is sitting there. Why isn't he coming for the ball then? Yes. I am sure you have many questions. Yeah. Yes, will we get to help plan the celestial ball? A student will be elected to lead the decorating committee, Miss Hayward. Can I bring the date to the ball? I mean a person, not the fruit. I love that line. I love it. I read it in the data mind spoilers. I knew Barnaby's line. That was Barnaby's line. I knew it. Yes, everyone may attend the ball with the classmate as a guest, Mr. Lee. What's the dress code for the ball? At least he's wearing his pottery scarf this time. The dress code, Mr. Agu, is formal. Students, you are dismissed to return to class. More details about the celestial ball will be provided in time. I can't wait, this is so exciting. What do you make of this celestial ball, Silvers? I'm surprised you're asking for my opinion, but... excited. Celestial ball sounds like a lot of fun. I can't wait. Why are you asking me? Of course you would say that. Of course I would say that. Why are you asking me? I'm the jumpy Hufflepuff. I don't want to argue with you right now, Marula. I am in a very good mood right now. I am so in a good mood. I just want to talk with my friends and learn more about what to expect at the selection ball. I want to wear a pretty dress. I can't decide between the dresses, man. I mean, the floral one is so good. But the stars in... I have got this break. I hope I have time for it. Done. Right on. Because Dumbledore liked your question. You're very likable. And I don't even mean that sarcastically. I usually, when I say that sentence, I mean it sarcastically, but in Barnaby's case, I'm serious. I am stupid and I should stop talking, but I cannot. I think I missed some dialogue, you know, for Liz and Charlie. Oops. Please continue your conversation about the ball later. You were dismissed to return to class. Yeah. Uh-huh. The election for the head of the decorating committee will be held in the library soon after. I don't understand how election works in Hogwarts, but that is rather impromptu. Sarahi, can you meet me in the artifact room later? It's about the celestial world. Okay. Of course. Is everything okay, Penny? Yes, everything is brilliant. See you soon. One thing I should see, this Celestial Ball side quest. This is year 4's quest. Wow, that is Penny. You look beautiful, man. Yeah, this something I was forgetting. Yeah, what I had forgotten is turning the airplane mode off. Again. Is it recording? Yeah, it's recording. Now I can go. And meet Penny. Because I'm excited as. And I cannot tone down my volume. And everybody else in my house is sleeping right now. So, rip sleep, because I am being very loud right now and I cannot help it. Please stop loading. Huh? Wait a minute, Penny was so happy when she left the Great Hall. Why is she so sad now? Thanks for meeting me, Sarahi. What's wrong, Penny? You were so happy earlier. I meant to ask if you'd join the Celestial Ball Decorating Committee if I'm elected to lead it. Okay. But I may not be elected to lead the committee at all. Bye. Oh, I see. I wasn't sure what you had wanted to talk about. Huh? What had you hoped I'd want to talk about? Dates, I think. I was hoping you'd want to talk about who we'd like to bring to the Celestial Ball. I can't even think about a date until the decorating begins. Yeah, okay, I see your point. You're the most popular witch in our year. Of course you'll be elected to lead the decorating committee. No questions asked. Not if Emily Tyler has her way. She wants to lead the committee. Oh no, not this girl again. Okay. No bad words on YouTube. No. I just dealt with that girl last week. I'm not dealing with her this week too. Come on. Although I would like to see her get roasted. I read that on the data mine spoilers and she was roasted. Bill literally roasted her. Well, we literally. Barnaby did the best roast. Yeah, I'm ready to deal with it. Emily Tyler, Bill Weasley once had a crush on her. She was awful to him. You remember last week she took Isabella's diary? It's rumored that Emily is running a negative campaign against me. Yeah, like anything could get you into the negatives. Apparently, Emily just likes to head student committees. And she's unafraid to speak rubbish about me to anyone who will listen. How many listen? Please help me to win the election, Sarahi. Oh, okay, okay. First, tell me everything you know. I'll help you. There are no questions asked. I obviously will help you. Is the volume full? Yeah, volume full. I can't spread rumors. I'm too polite. That is the exact same problem I have. I like stars, I love them. Sometimes you gotta stop being polite if you wanna get anywhere. I had to learn that the hard way. Really. Yeah, people can be too nice. I'm too nice. Otherwise, if I wasn't too nice, I wouldn't have helped Ismelda last week. Okay, don't crash. Thank God. I'll be so disappointed if I can't lead the decorating committee for the celestial ball. Okay, that's not rolling off my tongue. It's a very long sentence. And as you all guys already know, I'm not being able to say words because of how excited I am. Our classmates think of me as popular and good with potions. This is my chance to show everyone that I also have other talents, like an eye for decorating. I just look at Penny, I see some, like, she's good at everything, something like that. Then perhaps the way to defeat Emily is to promote your talents. Huh? So we won't have to talk rubbish about Emily. Well, we can talk rubbish about Emily, I mean, she is rubbish, but... Now, while Emily is spreading rumors, we'll spread news of your brilliant ideas. I bet I know someone who will want to help us. Bill? Seriously? Bill? Why? I'm all kinds of confused by this. Don't say, Jay. I kinda like this ship. I kinda like it. Watch us, Rahi. What are you up to? Really? You're asking me, a lovelorn idiot, what I'm up to. Hey, Ismelda. Resist whatever urge you have to talk to me. People who want to ask Ismelda, please hurry up and ask her. You baby boy. Are you still thinking about the celestial ball? I am. Yeah, I am too. I'll ask you later. Control my emotions. And Ben is still sitting like a... Hagrid is talking to Charlie, I assume... No, I'm not going to assume. Bill, how would you like to help further a good cause? Oh, I did not know whose line that was when I read it in the spoilers. Put it like that and how can I say no? So you'll help me lead the effort to get Penny elected over Emily to head the student committee? No. Come on! See? I knew he's not going to agree to this. So now I have to use convincing capabilities. Penny is our friend. It's rather important to her that she leads the Celestial Ball Decorating Committee. And why does this keep stopping? I understand, but it's rather important to me that I avoid Emily Tyler. That doesn't mean you have to go... Never mind.
You do remember how Emily rejected me? Yeah, I know. I sat there and listened to it. I wanted to punch her. Besides, her clothes are awful. But I guess I can't judge considering I just got that Dolores Umbridge outfit and I find it cute. I'm sorry. Yeah, that's why I thought you wanted to see Penny succeed. Did I read that sentence right? I don't care. Of course I'd like to see Penny succeed. But I won't get involved in anything having to do with Emily. Yeah, that's actually, relatable. So I have to do this, yeah. Yeah, I get it. Our focus will be on Penny, not Emily. That's not even a question. You make good points, but I'm not convinced. Yeah, you will be after I've gotten 3 diamonds. That makes no sense in logic. I can't exactly tell what the right are those chips? I want chips. The 2 diamonds are... I can't believe I'm saying yes. But yes. I should have had a bottle of water with me. Let's help Penny to get the vote she needs to show all of Hogwarts her brilliant dance decorating talents. Bill Weasley, are you being sarcastic? No, I'd actually like to see what Penny can do. Then let's go to the library and start campaigning. Come on. Lunch is over. Okay. There was something else in the... Oh! Please tell me you can still see the thing with the stuff. This recorder can get a little wonky sometimes. I have no idea what that word means. I just heard it somewhere and now it's stuck in my head. It's recording, right? Yeah. You know, I asked my father why I can't use face cam. And you know what? It's a good thing I don't use face cam. Because you people do not want to see my bedhead. It's 4 a.m. in the morning. Here. Where I am. Stop loading. I'm gonna pause. Recording okay. We were in the library. I'm nervous. I don't know why. Why is she here? Oh, of course. Shh. Seriously, where do Pins calm down? The library is at its loudest. Pins is going to be mad. That explains all the shushing. I've never seen this place so crowded. Okay. Oh, Bhanu is here. I knew that. I'm so anxious about this Leicester Ball election. Thank you both for coming to support me. Tell Bill about your stars decoration theme, Penny. I personally love it. I love stars. Picture stellar centerpieces and a dance floor that twinkles like the night sky. That sounds awesome. It certainly sounds starry. Ha! Hello, Penny. Nice hair. Shut up. My hair is nice. Good point. My hair is not. Isn't it? If you are trying to distract Penny from the election, it won't work, Emily. No. Somebody send this woman away before I say that word. You again. You'll have as much luck getting Penny elected as you did convincing me to fancy Bill. And Bill, why are you even here? To help Penny get elected. She has great ideas. But I have charisma. I don't even know what charisma means. Sorry. One of us is wrong about what charisma is. At least I have led student committees. I bet Penny can't even lead a dog on a lead. It's a leash. That's what I'll tell everyone. Yeah, you think people is gonna believe you? Now watch me win. Yeah, we're gonna watch you lose. Perhaps Emily is right. She has more experience than I do. And she's so determined. Yeah, but she's a bad person. Don't give up, Penny. Let's get you some votes. Yeah, that sounds about right. I never had a school dance when I was in school. Actually I did. But it was in 5th grade. That does not count as a dance. It was a camp. How many times can I vote? Somebody explain democracy to this boy. No, I don't have to explain democracy to this boy. I just have to tell him you vote once. If you could vote multiple times, nothing would be a problem. I like stars. Oh man. I don't know why, but this feels ridiculous. Why? I can't decide how to make this decision. Ben, come on, do something useful with your life. The votes have been counted and... Miss Haywood wins. She will lead the Celestial Ball Decorating Committee. I cannot say that. One more time. Yes. Thank you, everyone. And now she will shush. Shush. This is still the library. Sorry, I just want to let everyone know we'll have a beautiful star-filled celestial ball. I need water, man. Congratulations, Penny. How can this be? I thought all of my friends would vote. Yeah, how many of those do you have? Perhaps all your friends did vote. How many friends do you have? 1, 2. Banavi is not out to itself to Emily. He is genuinely counting. This is the best roast ever. I love this. Very well then. Now everyone get back to quietly studying or leave the library at once. I can't thank you enough for believing in me. Obviously. Of course, Penny. I'm glad we could help. I hope you'll help me make the I hope you'll help me make the decorations too. Meet me in the charms classroom. Don't think you'll rope me into making decorations, Rahi. My work here is done. Damn it. Thanks again, Bill. I know it must have been awkward to be around Emily. But does it really have to be that awkward? Well, I guess yeah. But your help meant quite a lot to Penny. And it seems Penny means quite a lot to you. Okay, not me. Of course, Penny has been a good friend to me. She's always helpful. I'm glad I could help her in return. It's been fun hanging out with you, Sarai, but I should get to class. And I'm off to make celestial ball decorations. Bye-bye. I can't wait to see who else Penny picks for the decorating committee. When it comes to stars, I'm good at it. Have you seen my bag? Yeah, wait 1 minute. Something wonky is going on. I should stop. I fixed the wonky stuff. Now I can go. This word wonky, why is it stuck in my head? Why does it look like I have to duel someone in the class? Barnaby joined the decorating committee? Is this day lucky or what? Let's craft some daring decorations. Should clumsy witches be trusted with scissors? No! I guess. I can't say. I know absolutely nothing about making decorations. No worries. Just sit down and be cute. Thank you for letting us use your classroom to make decorations for the celestial ball, Professor Flitwick. Of course, I look forward to seeing the final results. Will you be chaperoning the ball? Indeed, perhaps you'll even see me on the dance floor. Nice. I certainly hope so. Ads, don't come, please. Oh, I hope it doesn't come during the dance. That'll be horrible. Enjoy making your decorations, students. I've been wanting to try some new spells. No magic, please. It's for your safety. I can't stay to supervise you. And mistakes can happen, especially when trying new spells. I'd like my classroom in one piece when I return. Okay, a little magic? When Flitwick said no magic, he meant no magic, Tulip. As head of our decorating committee, I am responsible for keeping order. Oh man, Penny! Just a little magic. I thought making decorations was going to be fun. It will be great fun. We'll make some brilliant decorations. But where are snacks? I joined committees for the snacks. Really? Are there snacks in committees? I have never been in one personally. Let's just begin crafting the decorations. If Barnaby's adorableness is rubbing off me again. Everything's better with glitter. Are any of us here good dancers? I know I'm not a good dancer, but I made my MC one. I made my MC a good dancer. Okay, don't eat glue. Jam City, stop making Barnaby look this dumb. Have we run out of paste? Yeah, because you ate it. Why am I laughing? I'll be flying solo to the celestial ball. A date will slow me down. True, actually. For some people that is true. I'm pretty good with decorations, if I do say so myself. I used to help for the Christmas decorations in my class. In school. It turned out pretty good. Before they stopped using students' help for decorations. Marvelous work, everyone. Though something is still missing. Yes, magic. But Flitwick said no magic. Only because he's afraid we'll botch things. We won't. What if something goes wrong? I don't want to risk using magic when we were asked not to. No risk, no reward. Using magic could result in better decorations. But if Flitwick finds out, it could cost me my role on the decorating committee. She's got a point. Let's just not use magic. What do you think, Sarahi? I think there could be major consequences either way. Exactly. So should we use magic or not? You know what? Let's not use magic. Let's not use any magic. I don't want to disobey Flitwick or get Penny into trouble. I have broken enough rules. Can we not break rules outside of rules? Thank goodness. I'm glad Sarahi is talking sense. That's alright. We'll be proper and dull as requested. I'm having a fine time. Exactly how much paste have you eaten, Barnaby? Hardly any. I've been working on the banner, I swear. See? Okay, I said Jam City should not make him look that stupid. Yes, they didn't. Thank you. I see you've been busy. Excellent work, everyone. And we didn't cast a single spell. Sarai held us to it. I'm delighted to hear that, Miss Silvers. I imagine it was tempting to disregard my instructions. It kind of was. 5 points to Hufflepuff.
Yay!
Thank you, Professor Flitwick. Thank you, everyone. You've been a smashing celestial ball decorating committee. I can't wait to show you the results of our work. See you soon. That's done. I don't know that I've seen Penny this thrilled about anything. I hope the reveal of the decorations goes well for her. I suppose we'll find out soon enough. And why is Etsy looking so serious? Okay. Yeah, I gotta stop here again.
What did I just get? Oh. Yeah, I have Wattpad. You people know that. Okay, but we can see the decorations now. Let's go.
I can't wait. Everything is gonna look so beautiful.
Please don't load.
Oh my god.
I am actually dying right now. No, okay, not literally. Penny is giddy about our decorations. What's this, Rai? We've been waiting for you. Oh my god, look at the floor. It looks awesome. I can't stress this enough. Boy is standing right here. I feel like an astronaut in here. I know, right? I can't stress enough how beautiful this all looks.
Blimey, Penny, the Great Hall has never looked so stellar.
Why are you sad? What happened now?
I'm so happy you won the election over Emily. You've done a brilliant job of leading the way. It's been an honor. Thank you. And thank you for taking my side when our friends wanted to break the rules and use magic. Using magic might have made for better decorations, but I think it looks all right anyway. It meant a lot to me that you stood by me and kept me out of trouble.
Yeah.
You're a wonderful friend, Sarahi.
I know.
You're a great friend to me too. And I know how important leading the committee is to you. Flitwick says they'll even recognize my contribution and announce my name at the ball. I'm over the moon.
Yeah, I see what I did there.
Congratulations. I'm so happy for you. There is no lunch in here today. I very much enjoy lunch. Quick, close your eyes. You're not supposed to see the decorations yet. It's all right. We're not going to the celestial ball anyway. Why? What? You're not going to the celestial ball? Why? Not the same without my best friend. Excuse me. I see a falling star. I need to go fix it. Huh? Oh, I get it. Now, what's this about the ball? Tell me why you two aren't going.
Have the proper footwear. Oh, Andre will help you with that.
Studying? Rovan, live a little.
Oh.
Yeah, sure. How about you just stay with me? Yeah, they make me sweat too. I have hardly ever been to social events in my life.
But who will I chat with at the ball if not you two? Party refreshments? Come on, Ben. I don't even remember if it's still recording. Yeah, it's still recording. No, what if not goes to the wall? I'll not go. Sir, sorry, Sarahi. Ben and I aren't just celestial ball material. That you don't have to be celestial ball material to gum for it. I'd be offended by that remark if I didn't agree. We aren't social enough or stylish enough. Neither am I. Okay, not at the social thing when it comes to the stylish thing. Yeah, I have terrible fashion choices. Or coordinated enough. Imagine the stepped on toes and spilled drinks we'd leave in our way. You're more than good enough. Stop it, both of you. I think you're brilliant. You deserve to enjoy the ball as much as anyone. That's rather generous of you. Obviously. But we're not disappointed we're not going. In fact, we're relieved. Oh, Rovan, you in a dress. I want to see that. It's true. I stopped shaking the second I made the decision. Come on, Ben. But what if we could channel your anxiety into happiness and excitement about going to the celestial world? I know I am. We still wouldn't go, but thank you anyway. How do you convince these two? What? Are you sure? Quite sure. Even you can't convince us otherwise, so don't go cooking up any grand schemes. No grand schemes? Of course I'm gonna cook up a grand scheme. Big grand scheme. You and Andre will have your work cut out for you as you prepare Rovan and Ben for the celestial world with some help from your friends and professors. Professors. Class figuring class is starting now. I'm afraid you'll be late. Run. Okay. I'm coming. Climbing the stairs, and yeah, I'm not gonna make it. Oh, I made it. I'd rather be at Quidditch practice. This is my study phase. No time to talk. Rovan. Rovanna, she's making me depressed, please. Keep the celestial ball chatter to a minimum, please. Yeah, that sounds about right. Ben, I've come up with a master plan to build our confidence over the celestial ball. But that's exactly what Rovan told you not to do. Yeah. Do I look like I listen to people? Rovan said not to cook up any grand schemes. A master plan is quite different from a grand scheme. I love MC. If you and McGonagall's watching us, pair off to practice today's lesson, students. And while I understand you're distracted by the prospect of choosing your dates to the celestial ball, there will be no transfiguring frogs into princes or princesses today as described in Muggle fairy tales. I never believed in that anyway. Ben, will you be my partner for today's lesson? I expect there will be talk of master plans. Of course. Cannot stop me. Stop loading. Thank you. I should complain earlier. Yeah, I did. I'm hungry. Waking up early in the morning is a bad idea. Yeah, I did.
wearing dresses. I just like to wear the dress. Dance or no dance. This is a classroom, not a social venue. Is it still recording? Yeah, thank goodness. Picture yourself with all of our friends on the dance floor. I am picturing it. It's terrifying. Come on, with all your friends. Please let me help you, Ben. I believe that I can. I believe you two are not discussing the lesson. I was offering to prepare Ben for the celestial ball because he says he doesn't want to go and I want to go with one of my best friends, so that's that. He doesn't want to go and as Ben's friend, I think it would be good for him. As Mr. Copper's friend, perhaps you should respect his wishes. Perhaps I should. McGonagall is on my side. I feel slightly more confident. I will say, Mr. Copper, I have attended a dance or two in my day. And I will tell you that such experiences shared among friends can be delightful. You might want to consider Miss Silver's offer after class. Thank you, Professor McGonagall. Professor McGonagall likes dances. Well, she certainly looks like the type. I thought she only liked turning things into other things. I'd like to turn a friend who's afraid of dances into a friend who isn't. It will be challenging transfiguration, but I suppose it won't kill me. Great, that took some convincing. Just wait, now you'll have to convince Rowan. I am scared of Rowan. Rowan has made me scared of her. That being said, I hope my... Now... I'm only in the library to silently judge others. That sounds about right. You? If anyone asks, I was never here. Okay, that sounds about right too. You? You look like a loud talker. Yes, I am. I am a very loud talker, sorry. I just am. Rowan, are you alright? No, Sarahi, I am not alright. Do you know how many books there are about balls, dances, soirees, galas, fitas, formals and the like? There's not enough time for me to read all of those books before the celestial ball. I'm not a party animal, but I know enough about parties to help you. So you've decided to go to the ball? Brilliant. I'm not happy about it. You forced my hand. How do you mean? Before, Ben and I were not going to the ball together. Thanks to you, now I'd be not going to the ball alone. You overheard me offering to prepare Ben for the ball? Yes, whatever that means. Relax, no need to be angry. You're coming with me too. Before I knew, at least someone else was not going to the ball. Quote unquote. Now I fear I'm the only one in our class not going. I stick out from the others enough already. So just come. I'm not sure I've ever seen you so cross with me. She was like just cross a bit a few chapters ago. And now Rowan scares me. I suppose you have a grand scheme to prepare me for the ball too. I prefer the term master plan. It was meant to be something fun for you, Ben, me. For you, Ben and me to do together. What happens if I won't go along with your plan? I'm not giving up. Rowan, I'm certain you will agree. When was the last time we disagreed on anything important? I don't even want to hear your plan. Please go and leave me to my books. But you are the one who called me here. Alright, but I only wanted to help. Shh! What is going on here? What is this mess? Never mind, I'm going to stay shut up. So now you've both gone silent? Then you can work things out as we shelve books. Nova, don't make me want to cry, please. Don't be mad at me for encouraging you to try new things. Never argue in the library again. Don't load. It would appear some order has been restored to my library. I think some order has been restored to my friendship with Sarahi too. What? Very well, but my only concern is the library. Yeah, that sounds about right. We apologize for raising our voices earlier, Madam Pins. It's my fault. I should have never encouraged you to go to the ball against your wishes, Rowan. Perhaps I'd feel differently if I'd had time to study dances. Mm-hmm. Attending a dance ought to be more educational than reading about one. Are you giving me advice, Madam Pins? Perhaps you do spend more time here than anyone. I likely should get out to the library more often. And it seems your participation in the Celestial Ball activities is very important to you, Sarahi. It is, Rowan. This will be good for both of us. Alright, so when do we begin preparing me for the ball? That all depends on Andre Egu. Yay! Rowan's coming! I've misplaced my broom. Don't tell Hooch. Charlie, Quidditch or dragons? Do I need to pick a favorite? Never mind. No sign of Emily Tyler out here, right? Would you just get out here? Excuse me. If it isn't my favorite Quidditch player, how was practice? Favorite Quidditch player? Do you mean that for real? Yeah, absolutely. Of course, Hooch often picks you to demonstrate in flying class. You are the best. I didn't know you felt that way, Sarahi. Thanks, that means a lot to me. I thought Charlie Weasley was everyone's favorite Quidditch player. If he's not, he probably should be. I assume you need a favor. Yeah. Why would you assume that? Because you've never told me I'm your favorite until now. It'd be a good time to ask for something. Fair enough, I do have a request. Charlie, I'm afraid I disappointed Charlie. Oops. I've promised Ben and Rowan a style and etiquette tutorial of sorts. It's to help them get over their doubts about going to the Celestial Ball. Ben and Rowan can be anxious and awkward at times. It's a fine idea. I wish you much luck. I was hoping you'd help. You're known for your style. I'm known for my style. I never judge anyone else's. Really? You always judge mine. Well, perhaps I judge a little. In a constructive way. Mm-hmm. And constructively speaking, Ben and Rowan are likely beyond my help. Oh, come on. Can you just help a little? Unless you can convince me otherwise. I don't want to hear about it right now. I don't like notifications. I don't. Look at me convincing everybody to do stuff. I could never be that convincing in real life. Ever. I'm warming up to this. Andre Egwu style wizard. Thank you, Andre. Ben and Rowan will be so pleased. It's too big of an endeavor to tackle all at once though. Who's the more resistant of the two? Rowan took more convincing. Please don't crash. Then Rowan will be the first to get the star treatments for the celestial ball. Yes! Rowan in a dress, I can't wait. The three broomsticks. You can't try clothes on there. Man, my game crashed.